Hello there, everyone. I'm Zachary Van Zant, and welcome to the season finale of Gorilla Wolves. We have just a great episode for you today, and I can't wait for you to see it. So without further ado, let's get to it. Our first segment today is a recap on the history of Gorilla Wolves. That's right, folks. Today you're going to get to see what brought Gorilla Wolves to where it is today. How we got this good. The episode I decided to start with is where I think it all began, the episode labeled Pilot. The episode begins with an ancient intro and some even more ancient news. Roll the clip.
Welcome to Gorilla Wolves News.
Now! Hello, and welcome to Gorilla Wolves News. Today's top story involves the much-anticipated Benilde Hall renovations. The St. Paul seniors are graduating a month early in advance of Benilde Hall construction.
The next segment that caught my attention was about former student Josh Rivera and a potential voting scandal when he was running for class president.
Did you not conspire with Jesuit?
I don't know what a Jesuit is.
Did you sabotage your opponent's campaign in any other way?
That's a good question.
Now, obviously, the segment was a joke, but I still thought it was pretty funny. But enough of that. That episode, we got to see our first look at Gavin Patty and his infamous sports news. Make an important note, though, that the first thing he says before he mentions any real sport news is that he doesn't know anything about sports.
Now to Gavin Patty with sports.
St. Paul's sport news! I am your sport anchor, Gavin Patty, and I know not a single thing about sports.
Classic Patty. Skipping four, we get our first appearance of the dynamic duo Black Hammer and the White Nail. They're giving us a teeth-brushing PSA.
Hi, I'm Black Hammer.
And I'm White Nail.
There are many reasons why you should brush your teeth after eating candy.
Your teeth will turn yellow.
You'll get cavities.
Your teeth will rot.
You'll get stank breath.
You will have chocolate in your teeth.
And girls will not like that.
So please, please, just brush your teeth.
For me?
For you.
Continuing forward, we begin to see our anchormen, aka students, becoming more comfortable and enjoying themselves more. Skipping further to even four, we begin to see new creative liberties, new backgrounds, new segments. Here's one of those segments where Coach Dickens is quite literally compared to a character from Diary of a Wimpy Kid, as well as Miss Brett being represented not by a picture of herself, but by a picture of bread. You can't make this stuff up.
Welcome back to another Fantastic Five. Today we're going to be showcasing five fantastic teachers at St. Paul's. Number five, Coach Dickens. Don't let the no jokes all business beard fool you. This English teaching Goliath is probably one of the best teachers you could have at this school. Number two, Miss Brett. This woman made me fluent in Spanish.
And now for a reference as to where you are in time, at the end of season one, we are greeted with a review on the trailer of the now record-holding movie, Avengers Endgame. Further on in that episode, Jack Blossman raises quite the good question during an interview. He asks if Coach Bacon's beard is actually a sentient being. More on that later. Moving on to season two, we get a good look at our fresh meat. With some funny editing and a nice intro, we get a good look at what is to come. Skipping forward, we have our first episode, made by our Media One class. Guys, that's me! That's me! Keep in mind that this episode, while a great learning experience, never aired. In this episode, we got a good look at the future. We were focusing on the real news, reporting real stories. We witnessed the days of silliness past disappear, and saw on the horizon a educational, informative, and professional future. That being said, we did have our fun with Bennett Hayes and Gabe Simpson, who gave us silly and fun hipster-esque stories on things like energy drinks, rapper's jewelry, and robotic birds controlled by the FBI.
Hey, Saint. Wait, what? You already know what it is?
Stephen Dodolo, Nick Dufresne, and Brock Zorns gave us news on gaming, technology, movies, and television series with the help of the writing of Aiden Plochet and Colin Duvall.
Welcome to Gorilla Wolves Military Tech News.
Our seniors Nick Simpson and Mesa Samples, as well as our junior, Kate Eckel, gave us news on sports. And finally, to round our episodes out, I, Zachary Van Zandt, Clayton Cockfield, and Jack Bertuzzi gave you the news on the everyday important stuff.
Hello, I'm Zachary Van Zandt, and this is Political News.
Hi, I'm Clayton Cockfield, and today we're going to be talking about psychological evolution.
Everything from there was smooth sailing, right? Well, not exactly. A little thing came along called the coronavirus and tried to stop us. No matter, we said. Onward and upward, right? And that brings us to where we are today. And finally, the little something special that I mentioned earlier in the episode, I think I speak for my entire class when I say this, is we want to give a big thank you to Mr. Pereira. He's done a great job of teaching us and guiding us this year, and it goes without saying that the show would not be what it is without him. So thank you. I'm Zachary Van Zandt, signing off for now. I hope you enjoyed a history of Gorilla Wolves.